In the last video, we added quantity selector boxes to the shopping bag page and wired up the JavaScript for the update and remove links. In this video, we'll write the views to handle updating product quantities and removing them from the bag entirely. Let's start with the adjust bag view, which will be pretty similar to the add to bag view, so I'll copy that to use as a base. It still takes the request and item ID as parameters, and the entire top portion will be the same, except we don't need the redirect URL since we'll always want to redirect back to the shopping bag page. Remember that this is coming from a form on the shopping bag page, which will contain the new quantity the user wants in the bag. So the basic idea here is that if quantity is greater than 0, we'll want to set the item's quantity accordingly, and otherwise we'll just remove the item. If there's a size, of course, we'll need to drill into the items by size dictionary, find that specific size, and either set its quantity to the updated one or remove it if the quantity submitted is 0. If there's no size, that logic is quite simple, and we can remove the item entirely by using the pop function. These two operations are basically the same, they just need to be handled differently due to the more complex structure of the bag for items that have sizes. With that finished, we just need to redirect back to the view bag URL, and I'll use the reverse function to do that, importing it here at the top. Now that the view is done, let's add a URL for it. And then in the shopping bag template, give the form a proper action URL, submitting the item ID to the adjust bag view. And again, this will be submitted with the JavaScript at the bottom of this template. Let's open the site and see if it works. And whoops, looks like we've got a little indentation error in the view. And we're able to increase or decrease the quantity here in the shopping bag by using the update link. And you can see the total of the shopping bag updating as we adjust the quantity. We can also remove the item entirely by setting the quantity to 0 and clicking update. And there is a little bug here in that we can technically go outside the intended 1 to 99 range since we're submitting the form via JavaScript, but we can fix that later as it's not a critical issue here. For now, let's add the remove from bag view to allow users to remove items directly without setting quantity to 0. I'll copy the adjust bag view since again this will be similar. And let's update the name and adjust a couple of things. We don't need the quantity in this view since the intended quantity is 0. Now, if the user is removing a product with sizes, we want to remove only the specific size they requested. So if size is in request.post, we'll want to delete that size key in the items by size dictionary. Also, if that's the only size they had in the bag, in other words, if the items by size dictionary is now empty, which we'll evaluate to false, we might as well remove the entire item ID so we don't end up with an empty items by size dictionary hanging around. We should also do this in the adjust bag view if the quantity is set to 0, so I'll copy this part up there, and also fix this little typo on the pop function. If there is no size, again, removing the item is as simple as popping it out of the bag. Finally, instead of returning a redirect, because this view will be posted to from a JavaScript function, we want to return an actual 200 HTTP response, implying that the item was successfully removed. Additionally, I'll wrap this entire block of code in a try block and catch any exceptions that happen in order to return a 500 server error. In a future video, we'll use this variable e to return the actual error message to the template in case anything goes wrong. With that finished, I'll save the views and head to urls.py to create a URL for our new view. I'll call it remove from bag, and it'll use the same syntax as the other views.